The Niphonium is a 26-tube synthesizer and is now available as a plugin. In this review, I will let you hear and show you why this synthesizer is different from the enormous bulk of other synthesizers and why you should check it out. Hi, I'm Marlon and this is the White Noise Studio. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new video. The Kniff Audio Niphonium is handcrafted in small batches and is an analog tube synth which was first announced 8 years ago. You could have heard the Niphonium on the soundtrack of the movie Interstellar. Famous composer Hans Zimmer used the Niphonium on there. The real hardware synth cost around and above $16,000 these days. So the next best thing is this plugin by Brainworks and Kniff Audio. It goes for an introduction price of $199 or is for free in the Plugin Alliance subscription plan. By the way, all music you will hear in this video is made with the Niphonium. Brainworks has used their TMT technology to emulate the synth with its 26 tubes to make it sound thick. So tubes, which means harmonics, saturation, distortion and weight, and the synth delivers. There are many controls on this synth. This can be a little daunting at first, at least that was my first reaction. And I had to closely examine what each knob does and how it works to fully break down the functions. So I'm not going into detail of every control here. This synth screams to dive in and fiddle with all the knobs yourself, and I suggest you absolutely do that. There's a free 14-day trial available on the Plugin Alliance website. The link is in the description below. First, let's go over the global layout of the synth. Here are oscillators VCO 1 and VCO 2. Here's the LFO, the envelope 1 and envelope 2 for the VCA. Here's the filter section, the ring modulator, the oscillator mixer of the synth. Here's where you set how the pitch bend and modulation will react. Here's the glide control. This is where you set how the sustain and hold behaves, the feedback dial, and the output master volume control. Let's highlight some of the functions. You have two oscillators, VCO 1 and VCO 2, where the pulse oscillator and controls are only available for VCO 1. With this keyboard on-off switch, you can determine if the plugin uses the keyboard and MIDI notes for the pitch or ignores these, and uses the tune parameters and modulation only for pitch. The plugin will always use the length played by MIDI note or keyboard. With the FM mod enabled, VCO 2 now modulates the pitch of VCO 1 and you can dial in how much you want it. The four switches determine how they influence the modulation. Plus raises the pitch and minus lowers the pitch. You can choose for envelope 1, LFO, aftertouch and external sidechain input 1. And this goes for all the switches on the synth. You can determine a lot by choosing input and output sources. There's no lack of routing sources and destinations. You can also use sidechain audio, called external CV on the synth, as a source for modulation on a lot of controls. The master volume drives the harmonics and saturation and you can choose different colors. With the VCA boost switch, you can boost the incoming audio by 12 decibels at the VCA input and it will be attenuated by 12 dB at the VCA output. There's a large preset list which you can find up here and it's nicely divided in categories. I suggest to at least go through a bunch of presets to hear what the synth sounds like and how versatile it can be. And there's a plugin preset player which I find kind of funny, but it's excellent if you want to check out presets. You can set the number of bars to when it will switch to the next preset. You can change the size of the plugin here. And then there is this little icon which will unleash more power. There's a complete effects section added to the synth. Reminds me of Lego. Plugin Alliance has all of these effect plugins and they have selected a few truncated plugins, a sort of go-to plugins to enhance the synth sounds you created. If you have the code, why not use it? The plugins are Delay, Flanger, Distortion, Phaser, EQ, the Airband EQ, Wave Folder, Chorus and a Reverb. These plugins can be used in any order you want. That makes it flexible and they can all be enabled or disabled to fit what you need. And you can lock every parameter like this. These effects are all inserted after the synth sound, so it's really an effects rack where you plug in the synth. You can bypass all effects with this knob. Below here, you find the arpeggiator settings. It offers a few modes and also panning and timing. There's no step sequencer, this would have been nice for more flexibility. You have to do it in the MIDI track itself if you want an arpeggiator to do something else than presented here. If you need more voices on your patch, you can set it in the options here. 1, 2, 4, 8 voices maximum. This options menu also offers settings for TMT, aftertouch and unison. And all knobs can be assigned to a hardware MIDI controller if you want more hands-on control. Enable the MIDI Learn knob here. Okay, let's go over the background music you hear. It's actually 4 Niphoniums running at the same time. The sounds are all based on presets of the Niphonium. Here's an arpeggiated lead, a bassline, here's a kick, and here's a clap. I will go through them and tweak here and there so you get a glimpse of what the Niphonium can do. As you could hear in the review, the Niphonium sounds really good, has grit and weight due to the modeling of all 26 tubes. It's flexible, can be daunting, but dive into it and spend a bit of time with it, it will be worth it. If you want to see another review of a synthesizer which goes pretty deep, check out my Waves OVox review. Please remember to subscribe to my channel and like this video. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!